Please, I beg by the mercy of God, all eyes bound, all eyes bound, all eyes closed.
Yeah.
We want to be sure so that these prayers that we are going to pray today will not be in vain at all. Hey, don't play with today. After 40 days, Jesus entered fully into his ministry. This is the 40th day of this fast. How did it coincide with our prayer service? It can only be God. I beg you by the mercy of God, if today you are not in right standing with God, you know beyond any doubt that you're not in right standing. Raise up your hand quickly, just so that you just want to surrender to him wherever you are. Just raise up that hand quickly. God bless you. God bless you. Wherever you are, please don't get something special about today. Who else again wants to say, yes, that's a hand over there. Don't play with fire, because I tell you, the fire will come, it can do two things. It can kill, it can deliver. Please, I beg you, by the mercy of God. Anybody else has a hand over there? Let's just move very quickly. God told me clearly, he said, tell the people to repent, because I'm coming. He said, I'm coming. There's another hand over there. He says, I'm coming. He said, declare. He said, don't continue with the prayer until they repent, so that my power can fully be revealed. He said, I want to move up amongst my people. He said, I want to repair that would have been broken down. I want to fix that would have been messed up. He says, I'm coming like I've never come before. Thus said the Lord God. He said, I'm coming to visit my people. He said, I'm coming to visit my people. Anybody else, wherever you are, another hand again. Please repent. He says, repent. He said, don't continue. Don't continue in whatever state that you are in. Anybody else? I will break protocol. You must come forward afterwards. You go back to your seat. Please, please come forward. Before we move ahead, please come forward. Very quickly. Very quickly. Anybody else wants to join them? Fire is falling today. God has shown me clearly. He says, I'm coming to fix. I'm coming to sort out. I'm coming to repair. Just begin to come quickly. God loves you. He wants to heal. He wants to deliver. The days of delay are over. Anybody else? Anybody else? Please join them. Please join them. Wherever you are, you know beyond any doubt. It doesn't matter whether you're a worker. It doesn't matter whether you're a minister. If you have something to struggle with God, something like now. Oh, shaka, na, 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 na. The rest of you will need to pray the Holy Ghost wherever you are. Shake the head, let me come to some other day. Look, the dead body can set you. All kind of affliction and corruption. Anybody else wants to join me? I will wait for you. I will wait for you. I will wait for you. But the people say, take me this. But the people say, take me this. But the people go. Surrender your life to Jesus. Give your life to Jesus quickly. But let the robots. Let do the work for them again. Come. I wait. Let the king. He wants to move. He wants to move. Don't resist the power. Don't deny the power. Anybody else? He wants to heal you. Please say after me, Heavenly Father, I come to you today by the only way of the blood of the Lamb. Lord Jesus, acknowledge that I have fallen short of your glory. Today, wash away my sins completely. completely accept me today. Write my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. Today, I become yours. And today, you become mine. Thank you for saving my soul. In Jesus' name, I pray. Now, let me pray for you. My Father and my God, look upon your sons and your daughters today and have mercy according to your loving kindness, according to the multitude of your tender mercies. Blot out their transgressions completely. Write their name today in the Lamb's Book of Life. Today, God Almighty, they become yours. And today, they become theirs. Thank you for saving their souls. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Now, quietly take your cards and go back to your seat. But please, immediately after this service, we'll invite you out again. But fill the cards wherever you are. Fill the cards, fill the cards. Okay, all right, please fill the card before you go. Just go to the back while I still pray. The rest of you begin to pray, the Holy Ghost continue. Let me keep up, begin to pray. We have prayed that every altar of affliction against any marriage, against any relationship, just pray, pray the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. If you are tired and maybe, God forbid, you're not feeling too well, whatever it is, we can sit down because we're still praying. 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 10. There is something very important as the word foundation when it comes to the area of marriage, relationship, family. There is what we call foundations. A man called Jabez, if we look at 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 9, let's look at 9 first. Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. There was really nothing really wrong with him. He was a great guy. He was even more honorable, but there was a problem with the foundation. And the Bible says his mother called him Jabez because I bear him with sorrow. So his foundation already was a foundation of sorrow. But Jabez did not stop there. He took it by force in verse 10. Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, "Oh, that thou would have," that "oh" was a cry. That "oh," that was prayer. Prayer is what would change. Continuous prayer. Bible says pray without ceasing. "Oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed, enlarge my goals, that thy hand might be with me, that thou wouldest keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me." And what happened? The Bible says that God granted Jabez his request. Jabez decided to withdraw his name from the foundation of sorrow. We're going to pray prayer now. The truth about it is that there is what we call a register that has the names. The enemy knows, he puts it there. This one, in the register. Today, your name, if perchance your name is in that register of sorrow, register of delay, register of financial trouble, register of debt, God will remove it. Yeah. We are going to pray. Are you ready to pray?
Yes.
You say, "Father, in the name of Jesus, I withdraw my name. I withdraw my name and the names of my family members, and the names of my children, and the names of my spouse, and the names of any loved one from the register of evil foundations. In the name of Jesus, please begin to pray. Withdraw it by force now. Begin to pray. Declare and declare, I withdraw my children, the length of my spouse, then they promote Satan that year. Jekeke promos, maneke prakandu sakata, leke promos sata. I withdraw my name, the name of my spouse, the name of my loved one, the name of my children, the name of my family members from the register of evil foundation. Every evil foundation, Father, I withdraw it now. In the name of Jesus. Ramakupra kasetende, len ratanda yada daraba seketa, robo ki preleshta kanrebo. In the name of Jesus, I withdraw it now. In Jesus' name, manrege debo shakrege standaga, leke probo shike krege, granda yada daraba setende. Oh. Delays can come in all sorts of things. Delay in marriage. Delay in having children. Evil foundations. Father, in the name of Jesus, we withdraw it now. We withdraw it now. In Jesus' name, we pray. Before I call you to pray again, please let me encourage those that came up. I understand some people have gone back to their seats without feeling the cards. Your salvation is not complete until you sort out and give those cards out to the ushers or the follow-up department. Very important, we've got to take your name, we've got to pray over it, and we've got to follow you up. Very important, let us obey God in the name of Jesus. Now we are going to pray again. We are still dealing with the foundational problems of marriage. Look, the Bible says, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? And what almost happens is that these things are done, even we don't even know. You know who your great-great-grandfather was. You don't know what could have happened. But today is a day of deliverance. I said today is a day of deliverance. You are going to pray and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I render impotent and effective any covenant made on my behalf at any evil altar against my marriage, against my family, against my spouse, against my children. I render impotent. I render ineffective any altar, any evil covenant made on my behalf in the name of Jesus. Now begin to render it impotent, render it ineffective, it will no more work. This day, the 19th of February, I stand as God's son and I speak in the name of Jesus. I render that particular altar ineffective. I render it important today. Pray very well. This is a prayer service. I will give you time to pray. I render it to God. It must not work again. But God was sure. Enough is enough. There must be deliverance. People must marry. Marriage must blossom. Marriage must be fruitful. God's word, you must be fruitful. No struggle in the place of marriage. No more struggle. Everything that has been done, oh God, any covenant made on my behalf, unknowingly I did not know. Unknowingly I did not know. Father, I render it ineffective in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Put Matthew 13 verse 25. There are a lot of things that happen that we are not aware of. Be very careful about the people you invite to your wedding. Be very careful. Weddings sometimes are not for everybody. The enemies will come. The demons will come. And what happens? They do what we call seed sowing at weddings. I beg you by the mercy of God, those that are in relationships are about to get married. Take some time. Look, they are feeling 40 days. Okay, you better go and start your own in one way. Who was your wedding? In 7 days, do it. And the Holy Spirit tells you, 3 days, do it. You and your spouse come together and pray. The Bible says the heart of man is desperately wicked. They don't want anything good for anybody. I've seen things happen. And I've seen prayer change things. I know what I'm talking about. The Bible says the book of Matthew 13 verse 25. Can we read it together? Want to go? But while men slept, his enemy came, sowed tears among the wheat, and went his way. That's what they do. One my brother, one was drop it and they go. Then afterwards, 2 years, no children. 3 years, no children. 4 years, 5 years, 6 years. Oh, so things can happen. Or the man he got married is just wahala, stress, living from hand to mouth. Or they came on your graduation. Then you are not looking for the old man, you are waiting forever. The days of waiting are over in Joshua. The God whom I serve, the God who have cried unto all throughout the night before this service, he will answer by fire. Our daddy has said that this year will be our marriages. This year, marriages will really be fruitful and multiply. Thank God, Matthew 13 verse 25 said they came and they saw the tears. But Jesus came in Matthew chapter 15 verse 13. Put it on the screen. Matthew chapter 15 verse 13. That is why it says so that they will know that there is you are the one that has power. I like that song. They will know that there's a God that reigns. We are going to pray. Let's be together. I want to go. But the answer has said, every plant with my heavenly Father has not planted, shall be rooted out. Hold your hand, your neighbor. Oh. Magaba Gebra Gesotanda. No, we need to hold one more person. Just take it. Take somebody. Face somebody. Just pick a partner. Pick a partner. This one. We are going to pray. Pick a partner. Nobody added to hold it. Okay. Are you free? Good. Come and stand here. Man de cabra casicate. Don't begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. We are going to pray. I'm praying that song in the car. Nobody, you are holding the keyboard. God knows. Katika Bragusa Katana. Rede de Kedebosoto Yadabaseta. Seeds of evil. Seeds of poverty. Seeds of sickness. Seeds of disaster. You will hold your neighbor. You will prophesy into his life. You will say, Father, in the name of Jesus, every plant you have not planted in the life of my neighbor here, Father, by fire, root it out now. Jesus, root it out. Every plant that my Father has not planted in this life, God, root it out now. By fire, by fire, by fire, by fire, by fire, by fire. Every plant you are not planting in the life of your brother, in his marriage, in his relationship, in his home, Father, root. Root it out now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. If you believe that prayer, shout a big amen.
Amen.
Shout amen.
Amen.
Yes, we pray. You see, marriages, relationships, families, children, there's what we call, God says, I will visit the iniquities of the fathers from generation to generation. The blood of Jesus is there to wash and to cleanse and to break. But I want to pray a prayer right now against any generational issues. Maybe I do it this way. You will say, I declare my freedom. myself. It's an intergenerational covenant. Generational sin and problems in the name of Jesus. You see, what happens is that the person needs to do the renouncing. You need to do it. You don't know. Just perchance pray. You know, everything is going well with you. Fine. But you don't know what can happen next year. You throw bombs into the enemy's camp ahead of time before they come to attack you. You say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I release myself. I release my spouse. I release my family. I release my children. In the name of Jesus, from any generational sin, any generational curse, any ancestral curse, in the name of Jesus, begin to pray. I remove myself. I release myself. I release myself. Today, there must be deliverance. I release myself. I release myself. In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
spirits, I command that gene to be activated. The Abrahamic gene, let it begin to work now. It was not working before. Let it work in my marriage, work in my family, work in my home. In the name of Jesus, I command it. In the name of Jesus, God, I command it now, 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 now. Let me get the Shanti Kaba. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Now we are going to pray again to break the power of non-achievement in marriage. I mean, God forbid, that will not be your portion.
Amen.
Every marriage in this church must be fruitful.
Amen.
People that are still trusting God for that marriage, they must marry.
Amen.
They must have children.
Amen.
Marriages in this church must prosper.
Amen.
They must dedicate houses.
Amen.
Dedicate cars.
Amen.
Dedicate babies.
Amen.
Continually.
Amen.
That is achievement. We are going to pray against the spirit of non-achievement. You say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I break by your power, the power of non-achievement that might be operating secretly in my generation, in my lineage, in my family, in my marriage, in the name of Jesus. Break it now. In the name of Jesus, begin to pray. The spirit of the power of achievement, I break it now. You will be an achiever. You will be married. You will be an achiever. Your life will prosper. Break that chain. It's the chain that needs to be broken. I break it now by the power of God. Every power of non-achievement, I break it now in the name of Jesus. I break it now in the name of Jesus. I break it now in the name of Jesus. I break, I break, I break.
Jesus.
Oh God, prema santaria garabosta. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Now you can put your hand down, you're going to declare and declare with your right hand and say, Father, I destabilize, I demobilize, and destroy all satanic monitoring gadgets watching over my progress in my marriage, in my family, in the name of Jesus. Decree and declare, say, Lord, I demobilize them, I destabilize them in the name of Jesus. Son of God Almighty, demobilize, destroy, destabilize, let it no more work. In the name of Jesus, every altar of affliction against my marriage, every monitoring gadget against my children, against my business, against my marriage, against my progress, oh Father, in the name of Jesus, destroy, demobilize it. In Jesus' name we pray. Let me show you a scripture where that was taken from. Job chapter 5 verse 12. Job chapter 5 verse 12. They are what we call devices. What have you had a device? They are different kind of devices. People use devices for all sorts of things, technology. The same way the enemy use devices for all sorts of things. Devices so that at a particular time in life, it will be activated. God forbid. The Bible says, God disappoints the device of the crafter. I will use the message by Cindy Tree, the powerful American preacher. She said, Father, in Jesus' name, send viruses into their hardware and their databases. She prayed that prayer, Cindy Tree, powerful one of God. We want the device to scatter and break down and crash. You know, the tech guys over there know how painful it is when their devices crash. Their devices. You say, in the name of Jesus. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I stand upon your word. Disappoint all devices of the enemy concerning my marriage, concerning my relationship, concerning my family, concerning my loved ones. Arise! Send viruses into their databases. Send viruses into their hardware. Let them crash now. Command the devices of the powers of hell to crash. They will no more work. They will no more work. Let all devices of Satan against my marriage, my family, my children, my progress, Father, it will no more work. Let it be consumed by viruses. Holy Ghost viruses, consume it now. Pray, everyone. You never can tell. It's warfare. Sheke bra baze kalama. Mandre de bra du sheke bra. Father, disappointed now. Disappointed now. Le bra nebra gusta katagabashte kari. Oh, thank you, Father. Pray very well. God, disappointed in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. The scripture that says, and that was in Isaiah 54, it says, every tongue that will rise up against me in judgment shall be condemned. The heart of man and their tongues are desperately wicked. They make these things at altars. They make them at marriages, families, all sorts of things. You never can tell. Why would we not put that in scripture? We are going to pray a prayer from that same scripture, but this time you will say it this way. You will say, Father, let the blood of Jesus silence all evil speaking into my marriage, into my family, into my loved ones, in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, Father, let the blood silence every evil speaking against my marriage, against my relationship, against my spouse, against my children. In the name of Jesus, begin to pray. The Bible says, every tongue that will rise up against me shall be condemned. I silence it now. Let the blood of Jesus silence They will no more speak. Their words shall be condemned. Their words will no more walk. I'm also saying, we shall be the last of the devil. God will arise. I must prosper. My marriage must prosper. My children must prosper. My loved one must prosper. In the name of Jesus. Man retendra grande Diego Soto. Le quebrana diete sentaria. Man retendra cabo sentaria. Grande kinia bababab seke. Le me diaga soto copre. Le me diaga de dos senta copra nesta taie. Oh, man capranando cabayatari. Then regestandarie. Branele bosoto de bo. La grandandarie sacandarie. Oh, in Jesus' name we pray. Listen to me. This one, you will say, I don't have children. You are still going to have children. So whether you are married with children, whether you are not married, or whether you are even married without children, everybody will put his hand on this like this as we pray. This is a very, very, very serious prayer. Because sometimes, God forbid, you give birth to a child that you are always, God forbid, mourning over, always sorrowing over. These things need to settle in the spirit. God forbid you give birth to a child that is sick all the time. God forbid you give birth to a child that does not know or has autism. Ah, look, listen to me, ladies and gentlemen. We must prophesy over our wombs. As you are putting your hand on that your womb there, you are speaking to the children that are born already and one that are not born, and one that are yet to be born. Are you ready to pray?
Yes.
You will say, Father! In the name of Jesus,
yes.
I stand against the voice of the world that wants to call my children. I strike by fire that voice with dumbness in the name of Jesus. Strike it now. Begin to pray and say, I stand against the voice. You will not call my children or become from my door. They will not hear your voice. I stand against it now. Prophesy over your womb. The children that will come, the children that are there, the ones that are in, I will still come. We must pray. Silence that voice. Silence that voice. Silence that voice. The voice of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Leke praga nebos. Randa cabrada nebos. Lande canda nebos. We silence it now. In the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, Father. Pray in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Now we are going to plead the blood. The Bible says in the book of Revelation, chapter 12, verse 11. He says, we overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. You are going to plead the blood over your marriage, plead the blood over your relationships, plead the blood over your family, your children. When you plead the blood, it's a seal. You say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I plead the blood. I plead the blood. I plead the blood over my marriage. Over my family, over my spouse, over my children, over my loved ones. I plead the blood. Begin to plead it now. As I see, I plead the blood. 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 I plead way. Because whether you're married or you're not married, you can prophesy and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, the name that is above every other name, I prophesy there will be love in my marriage, unity in my marriage, joy in my marriage, prosperity in my marriage, peace in my marriage. Whatever you want, begin to prophesy now and decree and declare there will be love, there will be unity, there will be prosperity, there will be joy, there will be gladness in the name of Jesus. Prophesy. Even if you're not married, you can prophesy ahead of time and say, my marriage that is coming this year, in my marriage that is coming next year, prophesy and say, there will be peace, there will be joy, there will be peace, there will be joy, there will be peace, there will be joy, in the name of Jesus. Oh no, there will be peace, there will be joy, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I saw something not clearly. Am I going to pray about it? It is what we call a restraining order from heaven. You know, God had told, when the devil came to meet him concerning Job, there are some things that God said you can do, and there are some things that God said you cannot do. Don't take his life. We want to ask God to issue a restraining order for all powers and principalities that want to affect our marriages, our relationships. Are you ready to pray? We are going to cry unto God and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, by your mercy, I ask that you issue a restraining order from your throne to stop the power of darkness from messing around with my marriage, with my relationship, with my finances, with my family, with my children. Begin to decree. Issue it. Ask God to issue. Give us honor from heaven. In the name of Jesus, God Almighty, I ask you, let the restraining order be issued. Let it be issued. Let it be issued. Let it be issued. Let it be issued. In the name of Jesus, let it be issued. Let it be issued. Let it be issued. Let it be issued. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. You know, listen, when we were sharing earlier this today, one of our ministers was talking about strongholds in the areas of when people are just of age, yet no husband. It's not an ordinary thing. I think there are times we need to go, yes, what we call the time of God, but we need to pray. They're going to be called a strong man. The strong man saving for children, people are married and they're not having children for a while. There's a strong man in place. The Bible says that we cannot enter into a strong man's house except we first of all bind it. So bind it first, then now begin to wait for God. Not that he goes, they wait, I am not praying. The strong man doesn't want you to marry. The strong man doesn't want you to have children. The strong man doesn't want you to enjoy your marriage. We are going to pray and say, Father, I take authority over the strong man attached to my marital affairs. In the name of Jesus, begin to pray. Take authority over the strong man concerning my marriage, concerning my relationship. Take authority. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I take authority now. I take authority. Oh God. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Remember the book of Colossians chapter 2 verse 14. The Bible says that Jesus took away all ordinances, all things contrary, and took them to the cross, nailing it. You are going to pray concerning your mind, your relationship, your children, your family, your loved ones. You will say,
Father,
in the name of Jesus, according to your word, I nullify, I destroy all personal evil pronouncements over my life. In the name of the Lord, I destroy every ordinance, every handwriting of evil concerning my marriage, concerning my relationship. In the name of Jesus, now begin to pray. Nullify it, destroy it by the blood of the Lamb. The Bible says Jesus went to the cross, so you can claim it. It's your right. It's your right. You can claim it. I say, Father, in the name of Jesus, don't get tired. You must pray. It is warfare. Man, the God, the common. I nullify it now. I destroy it. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name forevermore. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
God wants to show for mercy here. I receive it clearly. Some things that will happen, it doesn't matter why you have committed an abortion, as long as you have repented of it, you ask the blood to wash it. But the enemy will want to use it against your marriage. All sorts of things might want to happen because of that. Now we're going to pray and declare the blood of the Lamb to wash. You will say, Father, in the name of Jesus, forgive me, O Lord. Have mercy upon me. If I have entered into knowingly or unknowingly any type of sin that is affecting my marriage, affecting my relationship, affecting my achievement in life, in Jesus' name, ask the blood to wash you. Say, Lord, wash me, because the enemy I want to use it. God's only in peeps of people, the enemy wants to use it against your marriage. Ask that the blood will wash you now. You enter into it either knowingly, sometimes you might not even know. Father, let the blood speak. 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 In the name of Jesus, let the blood speak. Let the blood speak. Thank you, Father. Give you praise. Give you glory. Give you honor. Give you adoration. Begin to thank Him. Give Him praise and glory. Begin to thank Him. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank Him. Just give Him praise. Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Bless His holy name for what He has done in your marriage, what He has done in your life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, King of glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Now I want to pray for. There's one I want to pray for. There's some single mothers. Maybe you're not in the house, you're in the house, you don't have to come out. I want to pray for the single mothers. Perchance, God forbid, either the husband passed, or you have a child out of wedlock years ago, yes, a single. That grace and mercy shall be released for that single mother. You say, Father, for every single mother or single father in the house, let grace, divine grace, be released upon their lives. In the name of Jesus, let's pray that prayer for them right now. For every single mother, one way or the other, where the person had a child in the wedlock, the blood of Jesus has washed that person. Father, in Jesus' name, let all God grace be released in the name of Jesus. Now we are going to prophesy over ourselves. Finally, put your hand on your head and say, Father, I prophesy to my destiny concerning my marriage, concerning my relationship, concerning my family. There will be no limits to how far I will go in life in the name of Jesus. I declare that this year, 2017, shall be my year of great achievement in my marriage, in my family, in my home, great enlargement in the name of Jesus. I shall pursue, I shall overtake, I shall recover all. In Jesus' name we pray. If you need that prayer, shout amen. If you need that prayer, shout amen.